Hello guys, so this is my board where I will perform signal integrity. So you can see the rats connected between the different ICs and the jumper. You can see this rat connection. So U9 is basically the IC, is the driver IC, and these are my different ICs, which are receivers and the jumper over here. So now going to the signal integrity application mode, where we'll this will allow me to perform signal integrity analysis. Coming to the tools tab and clicking on topology extract. Now I have to select the rat which will carry the high frequency signal. So that is C clock over here. Okay, so I will just view the topology. So it will open Sig Explorer, where I can see the topology of the connection from U9 to various receiver ICs. U9 is my driver, and different ICs and all present over there are my receivers. So the main thing is high frequency signal is traveling from U9 to different receivers, or U69 and different receivers. To just minimize that, let me just have a zoomed view to my U9, and it has been connected to U69 through this transmission line. You can see TL13 and TL11 to U69. So this is my transmitter receiver connection. In the PCB board, you can see my transmitter receiver connection. Okay, fine. Now what we have to do is we have to perform signal integrity analysis between my driver and my various receiver. So let us go with reflection analysis. So reflection analysis, in this measurement tab, you can see over here there are many different analysis type of reflection. You can do analysis for eye height, eye rise, or propagation delay, switch delay, monotonic noise, then overshoot, undershoot. If you just want everything to be analyzed, just click all on, and let me just provide a stimulus that is signal to my driver. Let me just give pulse to it. A pulse signal from my driver is being sent to all the receivers. I will just simulate it right now. Okay, simulation is done. Okay, so you can see on the left hand side the discrete format, how all my discrete data will look, and the sig wave where I can see the continuous waveform data. So maximizing my results tab over here. So these are my different driver to receiver connectivity from U9 to various receivers. So how many cycles are one? If I let me just select from U9 to U69. You can see different type of analysis and the results of different analysis. The eye height, the eye jitter, the eye width, the glitch fall, monotonic rise, overshoot, undershoot, the noise margin. So you can see in the bracket the unit of the measurement what you get. So you can see the U69 is highlighted, as I have selected U69. If I select any different IC, that IC will be highlighted over here. So you are just cross probing that for your better analysis. So these are all the discrete results what you get. So here in the sig wave, where we can see the waveform details in this probe window, my U69, if I click on the graph over here, so I can see the highlighted waveform of my U69, how the pulse is going. So in this way my pulse is generated from U69, but you can see my receivers are not exactly receiving. You can see some undershoot and overshoot over here, and some monotonic losses also, and you can see there is a delay over here, and again we can see some undershoot, monotonic losses, and again a delay. We can see some delays over here. My receivers are getting some delays. So what we'll do is we'll just select the waveform. It will just get highlighted. We'll just do one thing. We'll just hide all the other waveforms, and we'll just display U9 and U69. So let me just hide all the sub items, and let me just highlight U9 and my U69, which is connected to the third pin. Yeah. Okay. Display. So you can see I will just manage the connectivity between U9 and U69 so that my U69, which is connected to the third pin, will follow the U9 driver IC. So first we have to look to our parameters on the right hand side. We will see the transmission line characteristic. We will manipulate the transmission line characteristic. So we have to see which transmission lines are affecting my signal propagation from U9 to U69. So you can see the transmission lines are U11 and U13. over here. Going to my sig wave, opening my waveform details. We'll just hide all the sub items. Let me just display U9. Okay, display and U16.9. So let us have a look over here. We can see the delay, undershoot, overshoot, monotonic losses, again a delay. We'll see undershoot, undershoot, again a delay over here. This is happening because when there is a transition from high to low or low to high, if a high frequency signal have a transition like that, you will face some of those overshoot, undershoot, or some of the noise, because that is a high frequency signal. So this is the problem when a trace will carry a high frequency signal. You will have reflection, you will have crosstalk. So for this particular reflection analysis, we'll just reduce the impedance of the transmission line 11. We'll just reduce the propagation delay bit of the transmission line 11. Reduce it. Okay, fine. We have reduced the propagation delay and the impedance of transmission line 11. Let us again reduce the delay in transmission line 13 and the impedance in transmission line 13. Just make it, let me say 5 ohms, okay. And we'll just reduce the propagation delay. Okay, 0, 2, 3. That will be fine, I guess. So yeah, my transmission line details are changed. Let me simulate it again. We'll see the waveform in my sig wave explorer. Okay, let me just de-highlight everything, and let me just highlight my U9 and U69. Hide all sub items. Hide all sub items. Yeah, U69 display. U69 display. Okay, fine. You can see both the waveforms are same. That means my receiver is following the driver. So this reflection happens when you are sending some signal from the driver and your receiver is not able to receive the signal, because high frequency signal, when it travels for a longer time, there when there is a lot of high and low transitions, there are some overshoot, undershoot, or monotonic losses happens. So as I have reduced the propagation delay and I have reduced the impedance, so my driver and receiver, my receiver is exactly following my driver. That means whatever signal has been sent from the driver, at the same time my receiver is receiving the same signal without any loss. So this is what we can do. Coming back to our PCB editor, if you want to make the same changes happen in my PCB editor, I will just move the driver closer to my receiver U69. It should be closer. Let me just put it here. And the trace width should be much more thicker, as because we have changed the impedance, because impedance and width of the trace are inversely proportional. So that means if I change the width, it will change the impedance of the track. That means if the impedance is more, that means the track width is less. If the impedance is less, that means the track width is more. So in the top layer, I will just make the change over here from 61 ohms, which is having a 6 width mil. I will just make it 10 ohms, which will change to 91 mils width. You can see the difference over here. I have reduced the impedance. My width, track width has been increased. So based on your design parameters, what you will have in your board, right? If you have a lot of space in your board, you can just, just to avoid reflection for, thinner trace, you can make use of a thick trace. That means the trace width can be larger to avoid reflection issue. So getting started with our crosstalk analysis, we'll just add some elements from our add element browser. I'll just select the IBIS IO model, input output models. We'll place it on all the four corners just to create a scenario of two traces carrying high frequency signal. So let me just put the terminators over here as a resistor, and I will just put a interconnect microstrip 2 just to create a scenario of two traces carrying high frequency signal. I'll just create the connectivity between each and every connection. Yeah, it is done almost to the terminator resistor, to the microstrip line, and to the IO module. Okay, fine. So this is my circuit, and I think the circuit recap is done. So what is crosstalk basically? When two signals carrying high frequency signal, when two traces carrying high frequency signal, you know, travel parallelly for a long time, then it will start talking to each other. So let me just provide some stimulus signal to my drivers over here. I will just put quite high for this driver. Okay, fine. So we'll just see the transmission line characteristic. We'll just simulate our circuit and we'll see. Okay, so here we see the waveform data. So we can see whenever there is a low to high transition, we can see some of the noises, overshoot and undershoot is happening, even there is some delay. So because of this parallel line carrying parallel traces carrying high frequency signal, we will get some crosstalk. So that is 338.43 millivolts in this scenario. So the thing is, the traces should be separated between each other for a, you know, the gap between the two traces should be more, and they should not travel parallelly for a longer duration. That means the two traces which are carrying the high frequency signal should not be parallel for a longer time. If it is parallel, then only it will start, you know, talking with each other. So this happens with us also. If we travel to some other city sitting in a bus, if we sit with some other person in bus, right, for a longer duration, we'll start talking with each other. So the thing is, when we separate out, when the guy is sitting some other some in different place and we are sitting in some different place, we are alone, so we'll not talk with each other. So that's what I have to change the transmission line characteristic over here: the length, the spacing, the trace width, the trace thickness, the trace connectivity. These are all the transmission line characteristic what I can change, each and every trace thickness D1 and D2. So let me just provide a more spacing between D1 between D1 and D2 trace. Let me just make it, I think 50 will be fine. The space between the two traces should be 50 mils. Okay, so let me just simulate it again and I will see the, you know, crosstalk effect. Still there is some of the you know, crosstalk, but you can see some are reduced. Some, you know, overshoots are reduced. There are some undershoots though. So from 300 some value, it reduced to 19.09 millivolts. So there is only 19.09 millivolts of noise in my circuit. My loss of the signal is 19.09 millivolts. So this is what we can do with crosstalk, and this is what we can apply the changes in our board from you know, doing the crosstalk or reflection analysis.